In the previous video, I gave an introduction to bee trees. Let's continue and discuss the properties they must follow. Here's a simple bee tree. I'll note in our examples that the actual data we're storing, or satellite information, is stored alongside its key. But we'll remove it here to keep the visualization simple. Bee trees have internal nodes, and there are also leaf nodes, and a special internal node called the root. Let's discuss bee tree characteristics. First, each node has n keys. The node highlighted here has three keys in it. As you can see, the keys are stored in increasing order. Internal nodes with n keys will have n plus 1 pointers to its children. Our highlighted node with three keys has four children. The keys in each node dictate the value of the keys stored in each subtree. For example, the keys in this subtree have values less than or equal to the leftmost key, which is 40. Similarly, the keys in this subtree have values greater than or equal to the rightmost key, or 63. Likewise for the other two subtrees. This one has keys between 40 and 55. Another property of bee trees is that all leaves are at the same depth, which is the height of the tree. Let's discuss a few more characteristics. I'm going to remove the left portion of the tree to make room for text. Every node of a bee tree has a lower and upper bound on the number of keys it may have, which is called the minimum degree of the tree, which we'll represent with the letter T. T must be greater than or equal to 2 for bee trees. Let's look at these lower and upper bounds. Every node except the root has at least T minus 1 keys, and every internal node except the root has at least T children. Given our formula that a node with n keys has n plus 1 children. For the upper bound, every node may have at most 2 times t minus 1 keys. Again, given our formula, this means that internal nodes have at most 2 times t children. Let's look at a concrete example, since this is a little hard to follow. Trust me, it took me a few times. We'll use the simplest example where t is equal to 2. We call this a 2-3-4 tree. The lower bound on the number of keys is t minus 1, in this case 1. The node with a key of 9 is an example of this. The lower bound on the number of children when t equals 2 is also 2. Similarly, for the upper bound, we can have at most 3 keys, shown by the node on the right. In the case of t equals 2, the maximum number of children is 4. This is a simple example where t is only 2. Imagine if we increase the branching factor and use 10 for t. Look what it does to our lower and upper bounds on the number of keys a node may contain. We learned earlier that a bee tree node is often the same size as a disk page. Given this knowledge and further information about the application and system, such as key size and page size, you can make an informed choice for the size of T. I'll finish the video with a discussion on the height of bee trees. Generally speaking, the height of a bee tree is proportional to the number of disk operations. I won't prove it here, maybe in a later video, but the height of a bee tree is log base t of n plus 1 divided by 2. Using big O notation, we see that the height of a bee tree is less than or equal to big O of log n. In reality, though, the logarithmic base is the value of t. take a look at the following graph. You can see that log base 10 increases much slower than log base 2. Thus, if T is larger, the height is smaller, and we can reduce disk I/O. I want to end by giving proper credit to my source, Introduction to Algorithms, which is linked in the description. In subsequent videos, we'll cover B-tree operations and walk through code. Thank you for watching. I hope this video helps you on your computer science journey. Please like and subscribe.